To our games tonight, game one of the doubleheader, Bulls and Knicks, and we'll start with Chicago. Through 22 games, they are 5 games better than at any point in the previous 5 seasons now. Talking about a Bulls team that hasn't been to the postseason since 2017. Sean, what has impressed you most about what Chicago has done here through 22?
Well, usually, and GA, as you know, when you get so many key pieces together, it takes a little time. The chemistry, the personalities have to mesh. The ball's got to find the right player at the right time. You just have to learn your teammates. But it's come together pretty quick for Chicago, and especially when you're talking about DeMar DeRozan and Zach LaVine. They're the highest scoring duo in the NBA right now, 51 points a game. And the beauty with these guys, again, is just on how familiar they are with each other right away. I think they threw away the name tags after, like, the first game. You know, the introductions were over.
The stickers. And I like the stickers.
Exactly. And the way they find each other on the floor, there's no ego involved or anything like that. They feed the hot hand, and they have the right personalities for this. I mean, these guys are not A-type personalities. They're conformists, you know. They want to see each other do well. They want to see the team do well. So in the fourth quarter, when the ball's going to the hot hand, Zach is giving it up. And same thing with DeMar DeRozan. He's giving it up. It's beautiful to see, because when you bring together two big-time scorers, it doesn't always work out, period, or this quickly, and it's working out quickly for Chicago.
I love the idea of DeMar DeRozan walking into camp with a sticker that says, "Hi, my name's DeMar." That is excellent. And Chicago loves the fact that they have closers on this roster right now. DeRozan and LaVine are two of the top three fourth quarter scorers in the NBA, and that comes into play not only in close games. They outscored the Knicks in both their previous two meetings in the fourth quarter, but looking ahead to the postseason, when you figure Chicago will be back for the first time.
No doubt about it. I always say this, you know, the key to basketball is not about having the 5 best players. It's about having the 5 players that play best together. And when you look at the makeup of this team, you can always have 2 ball dominant guys. What's hard to have is 3. And I think the reason it works in part is because of Lonzo Ball. Because even though he's a point guard, he's really more of a space one. In the half court, he doesn't orchestrate the offense. Those two guys orchestrate it, and he's a guy that provides space for him. You look at the numbers of what he's done from the three-point line, and then also defensively, how he sets the tone. And in their entire culture, you know, Alex Caruso has been incredible with what he's done. Mm-hmm. Vucevic is now starting to figure it out, coming off his best game since he's been with the Bulls. And this is a team that, when you look at the landscape of the Eastern Conference, Milwaukee's going to be there. We know that. We expect that Brooklyn will be there. But they probably are going to be there without Kyrie Irving, the way it looks. And if you're in Chicago, you got to say, why not us?
Why not?
I mean, we have as much offensive firepower as those teams. We're as good defensively as well. And they've got great depth. And so this is a team that, if they can stay healthy, will only get better, because those two guys aren't asked to do things they're not comfortable doing. You know, they're high efficiency type players. They're not volume shooters. And Zach LaVine's really learned what good shots are. And now that they're playing this way, it's hard to guard them, especially late in the game, because the floor is space. You don't know who you're going to help off of, especially when you got a point guard out there shooting over 40 from 3. So this team's going to be dangerous, I think, moving forward. And this will be a great test, because from the Knicks standpoint, they're still searching as well.